Hello guys, welcome back. In this video, we shall be discussing about something called function and return types of function. So first of all, we must understand what is the need of a function. Well, suppose you have a code, and in that code you need to print the tables of say suppose some number, and you need to print the tables of that number say 100 times. So in that case, using a for loop, rather using the same for loop again and again and writing it in your program so many times is not obviously possible, and neither anybody does that. So what do? In such a case, we use something what is called a function. So what function does is, function is, first of all, let us say what is the definition of function. Function is a small block of code which is dedicated to perform a single task. Generally, a function is dedicated only for one task. Make a note of this point. But in many places you will find that there are several tasks that are being carried out inside a function. That is not what a function means, because a function is dedicated to do only one specific task. Okay, so if you would try to populate your function by performing several tasks, all of them into one function, then essentially you're writing the code exactly in the manner that you did before. So that's why we will declare a function such that a function performs only one type of task. Okay, so that is the very basic idea behind why do we use function. Now, whenever you used any variable in C, you always had a data type associated with that variable, whether it was int or float, long or double, whatever. But you always had some data type associated to that variable. Similarly, for function also we have something what is called a return type. So what is this return type? See, the word return is a keyword in C, okay? By now, you must be already knowing about it. So inside a function, suppose there is some value, say an integer value, and you want to return that integer value to that part of the code which made an invocation or which made a call to this particular function. We will understand what call to a function means, but as of now let us understand return type of the function. So what is this return type? Return type means every function always returns some value, whether it is an integer or a float or a long or a double or maybe a character or maybe nothing. If it does not return nothing, I mean if it returns nothing, then we can mention the return type of the function to be void. Otherwise, say suppose if it returns an int or an integer, then the return type of this function must be specified as int. If it returns a float, we must use float, that function name. Okay, so likewise. Now, what is the syntax of a function? See, in C, functions are written in a form that is, say suppose return type, space, function name, and then we open two parentheses, or the first brackets. After that, we open the second bracket, that is the curly brace, and we also close it. So whatever a task that a function needs to perform, we enclose that task inside those pair of braces. Obviously, when we will write some code, you'll be able to understand. So that was about return types of the function. Next, function can be actually classified into two types, two major types, that is non-parameterized functions and parameterized function. So what is a non-parameterized function? Non-parameterized function, as we shall see later on, these are some functions which do not take any kind of arguments, or we do not need to pass any values to this function in order to make a call to such functions. Whereas in case of parameterized functions, it is just the opposite. Okay, whenever you need to make a call to a parameterized function, you must also pass certain values to that function. Next, we have actual parameters, formal parameters. So what are actual and formal parameters? Actual parameters means, say suppose you are currently inside main, and you also have a function say add. Okay, inside that add function, or inside that main function, you are making a call to that add function. Now, add, as you can guess out, add is obviously used to add any two numbers. Now suppose those two numbers are taken as input from the user. So the user gives input in, say A is equal to some number and B is equal to some number. Now you want to add these two numbers. So what we will do is, from inside the body of the main, we will make a call to this add function. Now that add function obviously needs to operate on two values, because it is obviously a binary operation. So where do we get those two values from? So these two values we need to pass from the function. That is, we need to pass these values to the call to that particular function. You'll be able to understand this concept in a much proper manner when we will see some code. But as of now, let's limit our discussion. Now, formal parameters. When you are making a call to some function, you're passing certain parameters. So these parameters that you pass during a function call, these are known as actual parameters or actual arguments. And if you're passing some values, there must be obviously some values who must be capable of receiving the values that you're passing. So those new values which are receiving your passed values are known as the formal parameters. Now let us take a look at the code. I'll write a very simple function as I just described. Say hash include stdio.h. Now I will write a function to add two variables. Inside this I'll write int sum is equal to 0, sum is equal to a plus b. Okay, now over here you see sum is equal to a plus b, that is, these are the two values that we need to add. Let us first include our main function. So inside the main, say we are taking two variables, int a is equal to say suppose 10 and b is equal to say 30. Now I make a call to the add function using these two variables, and once this call is made, what I'll do is, I'll print the sum here itself. So printf percentage d comma sum. So see, over here I have two variables in our main function, that is a and b. Now I want to pass the values of a and b to some function, say add, which needs to compute the sum of these two variables. So obviously over here I'm passing two values, but in order to accept these values, I must have something over here. So what are those? Those are my two integers, that is int a and b. Okay, now the integers over here will not conflict with the integers over here. Why? Because these integers are local to the main function and these integers are local to the add function. Now inside this add function, notice one thing. See this void. Over here I have written void. Why? Because I do not want my function to return any value. If I would have desired that, I could have written int over here or maybe float. And if I do that, then obviously I will have to place a return statement over here. Okay, we will obviously come back to that. But first of all, let us see whether this code works or not. So I have made a call to this add function. Now see, notice how I have made the call. I write the name of the function that is to be called or that is to be invoked. And inside that, we pass the parameters or we pass the arguments that we want to pass. Okay, now let's save this file. I will save it as say function1.c. Obviously it is a C file. Let us save in the desktop itself. So I'll save it and then run it. Now one thing that I want to tell you is that over here this A and B are the actual parameters, and here the receiving ones are the formal parameters. So whatever change I make, that change will be local to this one. So say suppose if I'm making any change to the variables A and B inside this block, that is inside the add block, then that change will be local only to this add block. It won't be reflected over here. Now let us see the output of the previous work that we did. So obviously The first value was 10, the second value was 30, and hence we rightly got the output as 40. Pretty simple. Now, what I'll do is, say I don't want to print the value over here. Instead, I want to print that value inside main. So obviously, I have to return this. So what I'll do, return, return sum. So I'm returning a value whose data type is integer. Okay, so that's the reason why I have placed int over here. If I would have had this as say float sum is equal to 0, then I would write float add int a comma int b. Okay, so that's a pretty simple concept, and everything else remains the same. So what I did, I have just taken this printf statement and I commented it out. Then inside this I'm computing the sum and I am returning whatever this computation is giving me. Okay, now what I will do is I'll print this print at percentage d comma add a comma b. So whatever value I get, I will print it inside this printf statement. So over here what will happen is, see, I have made a call to this add a comma b from within the printf statement. So obviously the function control will shift to this particular function, or the program control will shift to this particular function. Once the control shifts here, this part of the code will be executed, and as soon as it encounters a return statement, it will return the computed value. Over here we have this sum variable to be returned. Okay, so this return statement will return this value calculated inside this sum, or the value that is stored inside this sum variable. Okay, once it returns this, where will it be returned? It will return to the point from where the call was made to this function. So the call was obviously made from within the printf statement, and hence we have add a comma b over here. Okay, so whatever will be calculated and stored inside this sum variable, that will be printed here, or that will get returned from this add function and will get printed over here. So let us see the output first. Okay, so clearly you can see the output is again 40. Now see, in the previous example what we had, we did not have any return statement. Okay, so that is the first thing that you need to note. If you are returning something, in this case our sum is an integer variable, but if you are returning any float variable, then make sure that you write float over here. If you are returning some character variable, then most probably you'll have to write a char over here, because you will return a character from this function. Okay, so that was about the return types. Now we come to the parameterized and non-parameterized. So first of all, I will use the same program to explain to you what is the meaning of parameterized functions. See, in this case I'm passing the values of a and b. Let's comment it out and write passing the values of a and b to the add function. So over here what I'm doing is, I have some values and I need to pass them to the add function. So I have passed these values to the add function. Now if I'm passing some value here, then obviously there must be some receiver for these values. So who is the receiver? Who is the receiver? The receiver is this variable and this variable. Just see that I'm passing only two variables from this add function. Okay, that's why I have an int a and I have an int b. Good. So that was about the parameterized. Now what about non-parameterized? So for that, what I'll do is, I'll create a new file. Let us say this is, okay, we'll copy the essential part from here. Inside this, say, I'm writing print name, or print, say, print country. You can actually do anything that you want. You can even print the tables of two. So what I'll do is, I'll remove these. Obviously, now that I've removed these, my function has become a non-parameterized function because I do not have any parameters inside the definition of the function. Now, by this word definition, there are two terms actually. One is the declaration of a function, and one is the definition of a function. So function also has two types, just like numbers or any other variable. You can either declare a variable in the beginning of execution of code, or you can declare it later on. Okay, and in this case, this is the definition. This is our function definition. So this is what we are actually interested at. The function prototype will look something like this. Say int print country. Okay. Int print country, and inside this we do not have any parameters. So this is how you declare a function. See, you need to specify the return type. You need to specify the name of your function. And inside that, you need to, in this case, obviously, we have an unparameterized or non-parameterized function. That's why we are putting a blank over here. If you have certain parameters to accept, then this is how your declaration will look like. See, in the declaration, it is completely up to you whether you will write the name of the variable here or not. Okay. For example, in this case, what I'm doing is, I'm not writing the name of the variable. I'm just specifying to the compiler that this print country method or this print country function will just accept two values, neither one nor three. Okay, it will accept just two values, and that is all that we will read inside it. Okay, so over here, if I'm receiving two values, if inside the declaration I have said that this function will receive two values from the function call or during the function call, then obviously you must specify it during the time of definition as well. Okay, so this is a difference between function declaration and function definition. In case of function declaration, you do not need to compulsorily give the name of your variable. Okay, that can be done at the time of function definition. And over here, inside or after a function declaration, you need to terminate it using a semicolon. Just like how we terminate these, you need to terminate this one also. Okay. But in case of definition, if you will notice, see, I have not placed any semicolon over here. Why is it so? Because it's not needed. I mean, that is not a syntax. If you do it, you'll get a compiler error or compile time error. Okay. So that was about parameterized and non-parameterized function. So, okay, let's save this one. In this case, what do we have is, okay, first of all, let's write the function. What I'm interested at is to print the name of the country, okay? Print country, is it the right thing to do? Let's see. Okay, actually, instead we can simplify this one. Let's say we are taking just one variable. And let's take one variable over here. Even this one is not needed, and this will be print country. This will be print country, and to this I will pass some value. Say a is equal to 10. So, okay, yes, this is the declaration. This is the definition, and inside the definition, let us say int sum is equal to 0. Sum is equal to a plus. Okay, say a plus plus. Return sum. So over here, what I'm doing is I'm passing two parameters to this function call, or rather I'm passing one parameter to this function call. So if I'm passing one value from here, obviously I need just one value to accept it, and hence that is what we have done. Let us save it. I have function 2.c. Let us save it. If everything goes right, the function, this value must work out, or this function, this program must work out. Let us see. So okay, we are returning the value of sum, and here we have a printf statement. Fine. Yeah, let's run it. Okay, what do we have? We have the value as 10. So sum is equal to a plus plus. then we are returning sum. So print country A. So what is the value of A that we are passing? We are passing the value of A as 10. Okay, A 10 is coming over here. Sum is equal to A plus plus, and I'm returning sum. So what will happen is, see, I have written A plus plus here. So obviously this is a post increment. So if it is a post increment, then first the value of A, whatever the value, initial value was, that value will get assigned to the sum variable, and then it will get incremented. And after the increment is done, I'm returning sum and not A. That's why we are able to see only a 10 over here. Okay. So if I do a pre-increment, most probably it will work out. So let us do print. Yes. So this is a pre-increment. Let's compile the code. Int A is equal to 10. Yeah. See, over here, what is the output? The output is 11. So obviously, that was sure to happen. So I'm passing one parameter. Inside that parameter, I'm passing actually some value. What is the value of A? The value of A is 10. So I'm passing a 10 over here. So once I pass this 10, for this particular variable also, I have the value as 10. Okay. So inside this function, I've written int sum is equal to 0. Sum is equal to plus plus A. So plus plus A means a prefix operator. Okay. So whatever the value of sum is, first sum will get assigned this value of A, or the incremented value of A. Okay. So the output was right in front of you, where you got a 11 over here. So that is what happened internally. So this is about a basically a this thing, parameterized and non-parameterized. So obviously, I have discussed with you what is the return type of a function. I have discussed what are parameterized, non-parameterized, and I have also discussed actual and formal parameters. Now, one thing to note is that when I pass the value of A over here, and I am doing a plus plus A, so this plus plus A is getting reflected only on this copy, not on this copy of A. This copy of A is still unaffected. What it means is, see, let's go to the end of the function, this thing, and write a printf here. Say printf percentage d. Okay, so I'm printing the value of A over here. And again, here also I will print the value. Printf inside add A is equal to percentage d comma a. Let us see. Over here, what I can do is in main a is equal to. Okay. Let us see if our code is all fine. Inside add okay, a is equal to something, and then a. It must work out well. Let us see. So over here, what do we have is, inside add, the value of A is coming out as 1111. And why is it so? Let's see. Inside A, okay. Yes. So over here, it's becoming plus plus A. Okay, and once this increment is done, actually there has some error has crept in into it. The value of A must not be actually 1111. It should be something else. So inside A, yeah, it should be something else. But what I need you to notice is that, see, over here the value of A is coming out to be 1111, and inside this main function the value of A is coming out to be 10. Okay. So what does that show is that whatever the increment operation is taking place, that is taking place on this copy, which is the formal parameter. Okay. And this was our actual parameter. Now in this actual parameter, as you can see, there is no change at all. Okay. So that is what the difference between a normal, you know, a parameterized and a non-parameterized function. So in this case, we have used a parameterized function. So probably that is all for this video. But before going ending the video, let us see what was this 11 for. Let's place a new line here, and let us place a new line here as well. So now if I build my code, thing is it takes a little time. Okay, so I am getting two values for a, and why is it so? Let's see. A is equal to 11, and then I'm getting 11 again. Yes, what is the reason? The reason is because of this. Obviously, the reason is because of this. If I just remove this one, then the value that I'll get is unique. So you can see. Okay, I just minimize that mistake. Okay, you can see in main a is equal to 10. Okay, and over here I'm making a call to this print country function. Now whenever I call this print country function, what is actually happening is there is something getting printed here as well, because I have placed a printf in this place, and also something is getting printed over here. Why? Because this function is returning some value for sum, and that sum value is getting printed using this printf statement. So that is the very reason why we had two values over there. Now let us compile the code for the one last time, and let's see what is the output. So the output is again 11, 11 and 10. So the second extra 11 is because of this printf statement. Okay, so that was more or less all about function. Now in this case, there are actually several important aspects, but you'll need to cover those aspects by yourself, because through this video I have given to you almost all the basics of function. Now how you will implement the function and where will you implement the function, that has to be decided by you yourself. Okay, nobody is going to you'll not find it written anywhere that you have to use a function in so and so place. So it is completely up to you how you implement functions in C. So happy coding. Hope you practice the functions at home. Find out some random questions from maybe a textbook or over the internet and try to solve those using function. Okay, so that is all for this video. Thank you.